Good morning. Good morning. God bless you. Good morning. Welcome to the Reignited Prayer Call. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, Mitzi. God bless you. Happy Monday. Good morning, Lady Kim. Good morning. Good morning. God bless you. Come on in. Sonya, good morning, Evangelist Rochelle. Good morning, sis. Good morning, Sonya. God bless you guys. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Come on in, come on in. I'm just trying to share this out. Y'all know I'm not trying to get this technology together. Good morning, Mama Norma. Melanie, good morning. God bless you. Good morning. Good morning, my daughter, Scoopy. Good morning. Good morning, Shamika. God bless you. Lady Vinay, good morning. Good morning, Stephanie, Diane, Kamisha. God bless you all. Welcome. Come on in. Come on in. Come on in. Good morning, good morning. Good morning to those that are on the phone line. God bless you. Good morning. Good morning, Evangelist Charlotte. Good morning, Bridget. God bless you. Good morning, Minister Shalonda. Good morning, Minister Tammy. God bless you guys. Come on in.
When I should have died. Lord, I'll never know why.
Have you ever asked a question? Good morning, Chandra. Good morning, Lady Ev. Good morning. Good morning, Jackie Borden and Diana. God bless you. God bless you. I'm just trying to get this phone together.
It's a mystery. I love you, Jesus. And now I know.
Yes, what it really means. Do you know what it really means to love? Good morning, Gwen. God bless you. God bless you. All right. I think we all right, you guys.
Your love endures forever.
Thank you, Jesus. I'm so glad his love endures forever. Are you happy this morning that his love endures forever? Good morning, Michelle. Good morning, Pamela. God bless you. Come on in. This is an oldie but goodie, but it's just a reminder. Love is patient. Love is kind. Yes. Good morning, Angie. Yes. Yes. What it really means to love. Yes, Pamela. Love is patient. Yes. Yes. Hey, good morning, my daughter Bree. Good morning. All the way from Fort Worth, my daughter is on this morning. God bless you, Bree. I see my cute pictures of my grandbaby.
The love of Jesus is all you need.
In her Valentine's outfit. Good morning, Jean. God bless you. Good morning, Regina. All right, we are going to go ahead and get started this morning. Right. Good morning, everyone. Welcome. If I missed you, forgive me. God bless you. Welcome to the Reignited Prayer Call. I am your intercessor for today, Jackie Morrison, and it's such a privilege and a blessing to be on with you. I don't take it for granted. I don't take it lightly to be before you. I take it as a privilege and an honor from God that He has entrusted you to be on this morning, on this Monday morning. So God bless you. Happy Valentine's Day. Yes, today is Valentine's Day. Woohoo! Right? Some people, you know, this is a special day for them, and some it might not be a special day for them. And that's what we're actually going to talk about today. It was befitting that we talk about love on today, and we just remind ourselves of some things in regards to love and in regards to God's love and God's love for His daughters, right? And so before I jump into that, I just want to welcome our newest intercessor, our new Friday intercessor, Pastor Kiba. Pastor Kiba has been on a few times already, and she has so graciously accepted the call and said yes. She said yes to being our permanent Friday intercessor. So I am so grateful. I am just so ecstatic, and I just cannot wait to see how God continues to move on Fridays through Pastor Kiba all the way from Michigan. Yes, all the way from Michigan. And so God is doing some things, y'all. We nationwide, we worldwide, we global, y'all. And so God is so amazing. He is so good. And that just goes to show how deep His love is. His love runs. It just doesn't run in Las Vegas, Nevada, but it runs through the nation. It runs through the world and everywhere. And anyone can be reached through God's love. And that's what's the most important thing about it. And so we're going to go ahead and we're going to jump into the word of the Lord today. And the Lord gave me the subject on today. What's love got to do with it? What's love got to do with it? Right. And we all think about that movie, right? But love has a lot. As a matter of fact, love has everything to do with it. Love has everything to do with it. So that is the answer to the question. Good morning, Pastor Dee Dee. Good morning. Good morning. And so on the scripture that we're going to be coming from today, and I'm going to go through this as quick as possible. I didn't realize I was just going and going and going, and I got pages. I'm like, oh Lord. But the scripture we're going to come from today is 1 John 4:16. 1 John 4:16. It says, knowing all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. For I am convinced, are you convinced this morning that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. So that's saying it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Angels or demons, death or life, present or future, powers, height, depth. It does not matter. It says nothing will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. And so as we look at the word love, and I'm sure this is going to be a reminder for a lot of you and just a refresher for a lot of you, I'm going to teach just a little bit this morning, is there are several different types of love. There are several different types of love. And so let's begin with the different types of love. And so the first type of love that we're going to talk about is the love is called Eros. Eros, E-R-O-S, Eros, it's pronounced Eros, and it's a Greek word, and the word Eros means sexual or romantic love. And if you guys remember the word erotic, y'all remember the word erotic? That's where that comes from, is the word Eros, and probably the most well-known word for love, right? The love in this form of Eros seeks its own interest and satisfaction. Come on now. Eros, the romantic sexual love, seeks its own interest and satisfaction. That includes love that's found in Song of Solomon. We know that Song of Solomon is like the love book in the Bible, right? Or even in unhealthy places mentioned where sex and sexual immorality become an idol for certain communities. Yes, some women have put Eros as an idol. They put sex as an idol. Some men have put sex as an idol, right? And so that is Eros. But God is very clear. God is very clear in the Bible that Eros love is reserved for marriage. Eros love is reserved for marriage, okay? We're talking about Valentine's Day to y'all, okay? So some of y'all catch that right there. Eros love is reserved for marriage. Then there is philia. Philia, okay? And that's spelled P-H-I-L-E-O. That's another Greek word for love. And this type of love is a fraternal love or a friendly love. Have you ever heard of the city of Philadelphia? All right? Y'all know the city of Philadelphia is referred to as the city of brotherly love, okay? And so philia is the love that you would show a brother or a friend, right? Who is closer than a brother, right? God loves the son, for the father loves the son and shows him all that he himself is doing. He will show him even greater things to do than this, and you will be amazed. Filio is another word, another way of saying that how God loves us, right? For the Father himself loves you. He loves you because you love me and have believed that I come from God, all right? And so philia is the most general type of love in scripture. It encompasses love for fellow humans, care, respect, compassion for people that are in need, the homeless, the sick, right? The poor, right? The Bible says, by this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. And that's philia, okay? The next type of love is agape. And a lot of us always hear agape, agape love, right? And so agape is another Greek word for love. And so this is a self-sacrificial love, a self-sacrificial love. And we're going to spend a minute on this agape love. And so of obvious importance in the New Testament, the word connotates a conscious action. Come on now. This agape love is a conscious action rather than an emotional feeling. Because sometimes we get tied up in our feelings, y'all. Y'all know we get tied up in them emotional feelings when it comes to love. Oh, he loved me. Oh, he said he loved me, right? But it's not an emotional feeling, but it is an action, right? And it's, again, common in the New Testament, it describes the love that God has. The 1 John 4:8 says, whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. And as far as Christians are concerned, John 14:21 says, those who accept my commandments and obey them are the ones who love me. My Father will love those who love me. I too will love them and reveal myself to them. It is also used in describing God's love for the entire human race. Romans 5:8 says, but God has shown us how much he loves us. It was while we were still sinners that Christ died for us. And so agape love is one of the highest of the four loves, of the four Greek loves, types of love. Agape love is perfect. Agape love is unconditional. My God. Agape love is sacrificial and it is pure. So if you have some relationships, my God, that are based on certain conditions, that is not agape love. Your relationship should not be based on certain conditions, but your agape love and your relationships should be unconditional. My goodness. Sacrificial and pure. This is what Jesus demonstrated on the cross by sacrificing his life and taking on the entire burden for sin for all mankind so that we could have a life everlasting in him in heaven. And so Jesus Christ demonstrated this kind of love to his Father and to all humanity in a way that he lived and died. That's why we read the scripture, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life or eternal life. That's one of the first scriptures that we learn and that we quote when we even first we get when we get saved, right? And so following his resurrection, Jesus asked the apostle Peter, and you guys remember this. He said, if he loved him with the agape love, then, and Peter replied, remember? Peter replied three times that he did, that I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. But the word he used was brotherly love. It was a phileo love, right? Peter had not yet received the Holy Spirit at Pentecost yet. So he had the brotherly love, but he did not have the agape love. My God, that's two different loves right there. My God. And so when Peter received the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, that's when he was able to receive the agape love. Love, not based on a condition. But after Pentecost, Peter was so full of God's love that he spoke from his heart, and 3,000 people were converted because of the agape love in his heart. He was now able to go out and minister and actually convert people and win souls to Christ because of the agape love. Then there's the storge love, storge, and that's spelled S-T-O-R-G-E. And this is another Greek word, and it's a familial love, the affectionate bond that develops naturally between parents and children. It's like when you have that baby and you see that baby the first time you see that baby, it's an instant type of love, right? It's an instant type of love. It's the love you have for your brother and your sisters, right? Your family. And there's many examples in the Bible that exemplify storge love, right? Like the love that Noah had for his wife and his children. He loved them, so he wanted to make sure that they were on the ark so that they would not perish, right? The love that Jacob had for his sons, right? We talked about that last week, right? The love that Martha and Mary had for Lazarus, their brother, right? The love that Ruth and Naomi have, and this is the storge love. So this is the love that we have for family, right? And I know some of y'all, I can hear some of y'all right now saying, well, I don't love this cousin, or I don't love this niece, or I don't love this brother or this sister, but we must have storge love. We got to exemplify this love. If we say that we love Christ, if we say that we love Jesus and we're in love with him, we have to have that same exact love for our family, our brothers and our sisters, our nieces, our nephews, our mother, our fathers, no matter what they've done to us, no matter how bad they've hurt us. We have got to show that love. Maybe that was for somebody. I don't know why I went to that, because that wasn't even in my notes. Then there's a few words of love that we found in the Hebrew language. The first one was ahab. And that meant just to simply to love. Simply just to love. There was no special significance, but just simply to love. Then there was the word dod, which was a romantic love. Again, that goes along with the word eros, for romantic love that was used in a Song of Solomon. And then here was an interesting one that I found. This word was hesed, H-E-S-E-D. And this word meant loving kindness. And this is arguably the most significant word for love in the Bible. It's translated as loving kindness because no Greek or English word has a one-to-one equivalent. And so this word means fidelity, not infidelity, but fidelity. My God, it means loyalty, patience, mercy, grace, forgiveness, covenantal faithfulness. My God. Salvation, among others, are all concepts tied up with God's loving kindness. My goodness. And so God's loving kindness, being a Christian, is not so much about believing in God. It is as it is as believing God. I'm going to say that one more time. Being a Christian is not so much about believing in God as it is believing God. So are you believing God this morning? And what are you believing God for? Yeah, we say we believe in God. A lot of people believe in God. A lot of people believe in God, but are they actually believing God? My God, my God. And so believing that he is who he says he is. How many know that he is who he says that he is? I've tried him for myself. My God. Believing that he will do what he says he will do. He will fulfill the promises. He will do exactly what you ask him to do. He says to ask, to seek, to knock, my God, and taking him at his word and acting accordingly. That is how we love God. We love God by obeying him. And that's how he shows us his loving kindness. And so Deuteronomy 6:45 says, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might." And so one thing that we have to understand, and we need to make sure that we really dig deep and understand, is that God's love is not earned. His love is not earned. We don't have to earn his love. See, sometimes when you get with a man or whatever, you feel like you gotta earn a love. So you do extra things, right? Sometimes you even do things. I remember back in the day when you were having boyfriends and stuff, you do things you don't even want to do. Why? Because you're trying to earn the love of that man. But oh, I thank God that we don't have to earn his love. It's not by our acts. It's not by what we do, but his love is naturally, his love naturally is already there, and we don't have to earn it, right? It's not deserved, right? His love is not deserved. His love is everlasting. It has no end and it has no beginning. God's love is not a duty. It's not a duty to him, and we should not make it a duty. It's not a duty for us, and we should not make it a duty to him. God loves us. He loves you because it's his character. God is love. That's just his character. He loves you not because of duty, but because it's who he is and it's just what he does. Even when we don't feel like it, loving, and even when we don't feel like, you know, showing the love of God, you know, sometimes we go about our days and we just go through these days, you know, on our routines and stuff like that, and we don't show the love to people like we should be loving, showing love to people. But guess what? God loves us regardless. He loves us whether we love him back, whether we do right, whether we do wrong. He loves us because his love is unconditional. There's not a condition that says, oh, only if you're righteous, only if you follow my commands, only blah, 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 will I love you. No, he says, I'm going to love you right where you are. And I thank God that he loved me enough to pick me up and turn me around, my God, and place my feet on solid ground. I'm so glad that he loved me enough that even in my darkest hours, even in my deepest sin, my God, that, you know, that sin that's in your closet with all those bones that you don't want to tell nobody about. I'm so glad that he loved me enough just for that. I'm so glad that when I thought I wanted to be in the streets, and I'm so glad when I thought when I was on my way over to a pimp's house and I was getting ready to enter into the game, I'm so glad as I sat in my car that he said, baby, you don't have to do that, daughter. I love you. I love you. And I'm going to fill you with my love, not the love from the pimp, not the love from anybody else, but I'm going to fill you with my love, my God. And because of that, I got out the car and went back in the house, my God. And he saved me. He saved me from a life that I did not want, that I thought I wanted, but because of his love, he saved me from that life. My God, my God. His love is action. And that's so important. And we have to understand that his love is action. And so you shall love your neighbor. The Bible says you shall love your neighbor as yourself. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. And we love because God first loved us. So what is God's love? So what is God's love? God's love is individual and it's personal. Guess what? He loved you just as much as he loved me. I don't have to fight for it. I don't have to, you know, do things so that he can love me more than he loves you. He loves us all the same. I don't have to, you know how, you know, listen, come on, can I be real with you? Y'all know when y'all had that certain man, right? Or you even might have that certain friend and you try to do everything for that friend so that friend can love you. That's your bestie, so she can love you more. She love the other girl, right? Or you had that man, right? And you might have a baby by that man and he got a baby by somebody else, but you want to do all these different things so he love you and your baby more than him, her and her baby. Come on now, let's be real about that thing, right? But guess what? We don't have to fight. We don't have to compete. There's no competition in competing with God's love. He has so much love. He has love for all of us. And it's all the same love. It's individual and it's personal. He knew you before you were born. He knew what you'd be named. He knew your potential for good. He knew how long you're going to live. He has a place for you in this world and a unique purpose for you for being here. And there's a seat at his table. He's just waiting for you. If you will take it, he has a seat at the table. His love, God's love is tenacious. His love is tenacious, right? God is undeterred by your busyness, your selfishness, and your disrespect. Oh, yeah, absolutely. He wants a father-child relationship. Y'all know, even though them kids talk back, even though them kids say things they ain't got no business saying, we still have love for our children. And that's the exact same love that God has for us, right? No matter how badly you fail, he'll be right there waiting for you to reconnect with him. He holds no grudges. God holds no grudges. And if he holds no grudges, why are you holding on to grudges? For what? All you're doing is just creating and building up anger and resentment and bitterness in your heart. So how can you properly love? How can love flow from you with those characteristics? God holds no grudges, so why are you holding grudges? God's love is sensitive. God never chews us out. He doesn't remind us of our past sins, except when he needs to guide us. If we're getting ready to go into a repeat performance, he'll remind you then, oh, wait, hold on. Remember, I saved you from that. Remember, we don't do that no more, right? He asks questions deep in our spirit. He quickens our conscience when we've done or said something that's not like him. His love is sensitive. His purpose is correction, not punishment. And I thought that was so good. God's purpose is correction, not punishment. He's not punishing you. You might be feeling lonely on today because maybe you don't have a husband or you don't have a man or whatever the case may be. Or maybe you have a husband and maybe he's out in the streets or he's somewhere and whatever it may be. God is not punishing you. Not at all. Not at all. But it's God's love that's going to get you through. It's his love that's going to see you through. My God, he's so gentle and subtle about how he moves in your heart. When we don't slow down or pray or pay attention, we miss this nurturing and this mentoring, this life-giving relationship with our Father. So that's why it's so important that sometimes we just got to step back and slow down. Sometimes we just got to stop and we got to pray and pay attention, so we can get that everlasting nurturing love from our Heavenly Father. God's love is long term. His love is long term. God is our friend. He's not our buddy. He is not a genie in the bottle. He is our friend. He wants what's best for us, not just now, but even long term. That's why he had to get Bobo out of your life. That's why he had to do that, because he says, I want what's best for you long term. And I can already see Bobo ain't going to be good for you long term. I know it doesn't feel good right now, but guess what? I guarantee it's going to be the best thing for you. He'll stand beside you when you fall to the ground, exhausted from the pressures of life, but he won't pick you up all the time. Sometimes he needs you right there in that place. He needs you in that place because he wants you to know, listen, I'm there for you. I love you, but I need you to get up. I need you. He'll smile with you. He'll get down there right where you are. He'll lay there with you. He'll stay quiet down there with you and let you decide what you're going to do, right? Because we have a free will. We have a choice, right? But his love for us, He'll stay near to us just as a perfect father would do. And I think about my children, right? There's some things we just have to let our kids go through, right? Y'all remember the saying, a hard head make a soft behind. And sometimes you just got to let them go through something. We can't always save them. We can't always do this. And sometimes we got to let our kids just go through it. But at the end of the day, if our child needs us, we are right there. We are right there, ready to help them and ready to pick them up from where they have fallen. God's love is expensive. God's love is expensive. God's love is expensive. He is perfect. He is sinless, and God is holy, but we are not. Our sin is the ugliest stuff, right? The ugliest stuff, and it has to be dealt with, forgiven, set aside so we can connect with him directly. And that's one of the reasons that Jesus came and that he died for us, to cover all of our ugly stuff. And baby, we all got some ugly stuff, right? I don't know about you, but I know I got some ugly stuff. And I thank God that he died for my sins, right? So we can have a clean, clear, pure love relationship with our Father. So in summary, as we go about our day, let us reflect. Let us reflect on the love that we are giving, and let us reflect on the love that we are receiving. Right? We always want to talk about what we getting, the love we getting. He don't love me right. My friend ain't doing this, doing that, or whatever like that, right? But let's reflect on what kind of love are we giving? What kind of love are we showing? What kind of love, right? And so let us mimic the love that God has for us. Let us remember that we don't need a bozo type of love, but we need a Boaz type of love. That's two different loves. Two different loves. Are you putting your love into action today? Are you putting it into action with everybody you meet? I even on yesterday, some young girls came into the church yesterday, and they sat on the seats next to me. And I know there was some people looking, and some people, you know, was like, these little girls, you know, because they had their little jeans on, they giggling and snickering and blah, 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 blah. But my heart rejoiced that them babies came into church. And when church was over, when they was getting ready to leave, I said, y'all come on back over here. And I gave each one of them babies a hug. I hugged them babies like, hopefully, like they ain't never been hugged before. Right? One of them just held on to me for even a few more seconds, even though she didn't know me. And I knew right then that was something that she was longing for, that she was looking for, was that hug. Are you putting into action with everyone you meet the love of God? Even your enemies, those that talk about you, those that spread rumors, are you putting in the love, the action? What love are you demonstrating today? Reflect on your love relationship. It's Valentine's Day. Reflect on the love that you're giving and reflect on the love that you are getting, because you are worthy. You are more than enough, and you should be getting the love that God has for you. You should be getting the mimicking the whoever's in your life, whether it's a relationship, a friendship, a boyfriend, a spouse, or whatever. That love should mimic God's love. One thing that I found out is that you can't show God's love through depression. You can't show God's love through bitterness. You can't, my God, you can't show God's love through your confusion. In a confused mind. And so if you are depressed on this morning because you don't have that significant other, because you're watching Facebook and you're watching Instagram and TikTok and everything else, and you see everybody getting the flowers and the roses and the this and the that, just understand that God's love is more powerful. It's greater than the flowers. It's greater than the chocolate candy. It's greater than all of that. It's greater than the steak dinner with the crabs and the biscuits and Cheddar Bay biscuits. God love endures. God love is everlasting. God loves you. He loves you. And so don't try to fill those voids with stuff. But go and seek him and have him fill those voids with his love. Amen. Amen. So I hope you enjoyed that teaching this morning on love. I know it reminded me of some things, some people. I had to ask for some forgiveness on some stuff about some things I need to be loving on more. And so we're going to go ahead and we're going to pray this morning. Most gracious Father God, we just thank you for another day, oh God. We thank you for another Monday. We thank you for another day that we have a chance, God, a chance to love on you more and to love on your people, Lord God. But we ask right now and we come asking for forgiveness, oh God. Forgive us for the times that we were supposed to show love to our neighbor. Forgive us, Lord, for not loving ourselves as you have loved us, oh God. Forgive us for not loving our children, Lord God. Forgive us for not loving our spouses, Lord God. Forgive us for not loving our enemies, and forgive us when we were talking and we should have been loving instead of talking, loving instead of gossiping, loving, Lord God, instead of criticizing, Lord God, loving instead of judging. Father, forgive us for that, oh God. Lord, fill us with your love. Fill us with your agape love. Fill us with your love and kindness, oh God. Let us show patience, oh God. Let us show long suffering, oh God. Let us continue to mimic the love that you have for us to our brothers and sisters, oh God. Father, we thank you for dying for us. We thank you for sending your son and for loving us so much that you would put him on that cross to die for our sins so that we might have a chance, oh God. So we might have that chance, oh God. Lord, we just love you on today, God. We praise you on today, God. Let us go out today and even tell some people that we love them genuinely. Give them a hug genuinely. And let them know that they are loved and that God loves them. Father, we thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. So God bless you. God bless you. Go out today and enjoy this Valentine's Day. Remember, it's just not about loving your spouse or, you know, your boyfriend or whatever, but it's about God's love on today. So go love on somebody. Tell somebody you love them. Tell somebody that God loves them. Give them a great big hug, my God, and show them that through your actions, God's love. Amen. God bless you. And we'll see you back on here tomorrow morning where Minister Tammy will be bringing us the word. God bless.